Hello students, today we want to start another new chapter. The name of the chapter is Linear Equation in Two Variables. This chapter is very interesting chapter. Alright, so let us start. Now what is a linear equation in two variables? Any equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where this a, b, c are all real numbers, are called linear equation in two variables. Okay, here A and B simultaneously they cannot be 0. Sometimes A may be 0, sometimes B also may be 0. But it is not necessary that A and B both will be 0. Alright, now let us take an example of a linear equation in two variables. Suppose let us write 2x plus 3y plus 5 is equal to 0. This is an example of a linear equation in two variables. Here you can see the coefficients of x and coefficients of y, they are not 0. The coefficient of x is how much? 2, and coefficient of y is how much? 3. Alright. Now question is, why these type of equations are called linear equations? If we want to get the answer, we have to draw the graph. If we draw the graph of this type of equation, we will always get a straight line. That's why this type of equations are known as linear equations in two variables. Now students, let us take one more example of a linear equation in two variables. Here at first, let us find the solution table of this. Suppose the equation may be x plus 2y equals 6. Here we want to find the solution set. Here in this equation, we want to find how many solutions it has. Now this equation can be expressed as, you can see, twice y equal to 6 minus x. So y will be how much? Y will be 6 minus x divided by
2.
Okay, now let us take the statement in this side. Okay, let us draw one solution table. Alright, let us put x and y here. Now let us try different values of x. If x equal to 0, 6 minus 0 is 6, 6 by 3 is 2. So let us put it here. Now in the second case, let us take x equal to 2. So 6 minus 2 is 4, 4 by 2 is 2. Then in next case, let us take x is equal to 4. So 6 minus 4 is 2. 2 by 2 is 1. This is also put in the third case. Now in the fourth case, let us take x equal to 6. If x equal to 6, then y equal to 6 minus 6 is 0, as you can see. So 0 by 2 is 0. And so here we are all taking all positive cases of x. Now let us take one negative value of x. So let us take x equal to minus 2. For some students, this calculation may be a little bit tough. So let us do in the rough. So y equal to, you can see, 6 minus minus 2 divided by 2. So 6 plus 2 divided by 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. 8 by 2 is 4. So let us put the last values of x and y here. X equal to minus 2 and y is equal to 4. Now in this way, we can take different values of x and we'll get different values of y. So what we can conclude? For this type of linear equation, there are infinite number of solutions. Alright students, generally some students suffer to frame the solution table. But there is a trick. Okay, so let us learn it today. Let us take a linear equation in two variables. After making the solution table, we will also draw the graph of it. So let us take a linear equation, 2x plus 3y equal to 5. We want to make the solution table. After that, we want to make the graph of it. Okay, so let us proceed. At first, let us take the equation, 2x plus 3y equal to 5. So here you can see the equation can be expressed as 3y equal to 5 minus 2x. So y will be 5 minus 2x divided by 3. Okay, this part let us keep here. Now we want to make the solution table. So here the values of x and y are written. Let us put x equal to 1. Now let us see the rough work in this side. Okay, so here if x equal to 1, y will be 5 minus 2 divided by 3. That is 3 by 3 is 1. So x is 1, y equal to 1. Now problem is, now next, what value of x will put? Here if you take, suppose x equal to 2, so what you will get? Y equal to 5 minus 2 to the 4, 4 by 3, that is 1 by 3. So you are getting a fraction, you are not getting any integer. So here if you take any fraction, you are going to suffer. So what will be the next value of x? So there is a trick how we can do easily. Now at first we took the value of x is 1. Now with this 1, what you will do? Let us see this in the graph. this 1 plus this denominator. Denominator is how much? 3. 1 plus 3 is 4. This is the second value of x. Then what will be the third value of x? So this 1, the value of x is 1. 1 minus the denominator. How much it is? Minus 2. Alright. So we have got the first, second value of x and the third value of x equal to. So let us do the calculation here. So when x equal to 4, you have found that y equal to 5 minus 2 for 8 divided by 3. On simplifying, we are getting y equal to minus 1. We are finding. Now in the next case, we took the value of x equal to minus 2. So when x equal to minus 2, you can see in the graph, y equal to 5 minus 2 into minus 2 divided by 3. So this is on simplification, you can see this is 5 plus 2 into minus 2 is plus 4 divided by 3. That is 9 by 3 is 3. In this way, we have got the solution set. The first solution is 1, 1. Second solution is 4 minus 1. Third solution is minus 2, 3. Now let us proceed to draw the graph. Okay. Let us draw two axes. The x-axis and the y-axis, they are perpendicular to each other. The numbers are plotted on both x-axis and y-axis. So here the you can see the first point 1, 1 is plotted. Then let us plot the second point. Second point is 4 minus 1. This is also plotted. Third point is minus 2, 3. This is also plotted. Now you can see that we can join them and we are getting a straight line. Now please put arrow sign on both sides. This arrow sign will indicate that this line can be extended in both the directions. That means there are infinite number of solutions. Alright. So in this way we can draw the graph of this equation. Here you are finding the graph is a straight line. It indicates that the equation is a linear equation. Alright. Now students, let us take one more example. Question is, draw the graph of the linear equation 3x plus y equal to 6. And also we have to see this graph intersect at what points on the x-axis and at what point on the y-axis. Alright, so let us proceed. At first, let us take the equation 3x plus y equal to 6. Then y equal to 6 minus 3x. Okay, so let us take this equation this side. Let us make the solution table. Here x and here y. If we take x equal to 1, what will be the value of y? Right, it is 3. Then let us take x equal to 2, then y equal to 0. Alright, now after that let us take x equal to suppose 3. Let us see this in the graph. Y will be 6 minus 3 into 3. That is 6 minus 9. That is the answer is minus 3. So when x equal to 3, y is also minus 3. Okay, now let us see the graph. Here the x-axis and y-axis all are drawn. And the numbers are plotted. Let us plot all the points. Here first point is 1, 3, you can see. Then the second point let us plot, it is 2, 0. It lies on the x-axis, you can see. Then the third point let us plot. This is 3 minus 3. Let us join all the points and we are observing that we are getting a straight line. Alright, please put arrow on both the sides. The second part of the question, it was the line intersects x-axis and y-axis. We have to find the coordinates of those two points. Now, from the graph, we can see that the line intersects the x-axis at 2, 0 and y-axis at 0, 6. So this is the solution of the second part of our question. Now students, let us take one more question. Alright, this question is from your NCERT book. So let us read the question. The taxi fare in a city is as follows. For first kilometer, the fare is rupees 8 and for the subsequent distance, it is rupees 5 per kilometer. Taking distance as x kilometer and the total fare as rupees y, write a linear equation in two variables and we have to draw the graph of it. Okay, so here main problem is how to frame the equation. So at first let us draw a line. Here the total distance is x kilometer. Okay, please listen carefully. Total distance is x kilometer. Here let us plot the first kilometer, 1 kilometer, 0 to 1, that is 1 kilometer. So the what will be the remaining distance? Total is x. This is 1 kilometer. So this is, then the remaining will be x minus 1. Suppose total is 10 kilometer. This is 1 kilometer. So remaining will be 9 kilometer. 10 minus 1. This is 1 kilometer. Then the remaining will be, yes, right, x minus 1 kilometer. Now for the first kilometer, that is for 1 kilometer, the fare is how much? Rupees 8. Let us write it at the top. Then for the next, that we want to travel this remaining x minus 1 kilometer. For each kilometer here, The fare is rupees 5 per kilometer. So what will be the fare here? Yes, x minus 1 into 5. That is, for 1 kilometer it is 5 rupees, for x minus 1 kilometer 5 into x minus 1. So the total fare we can see here, y equal to the fare for the first kilometer 8 rupees, and then for remaining x minus 1 kilometer the fare is 5 into x minus 1. Okay, so if we now let us simplify. So y will be equal to 8 plus 5x minus 5. Y will be 5x plus 3. Now let us make the solution table here. Let us put x equal to 0, then y will be 5 into 0 is 0, 0 plus 3 is 3. Then we take x equal to, suppose, 1. So 5 into 1, 5, 5 plus 3 is 8. Next we take x equal to, suppose, minus 1. Then what will be the value of y? Let us do it here in the rough. Y will be 5 into minus 1 plus 3, that is minus 5, plus 3, that is minus 2. Then in the second part, what we have to do? We have to draw the graph. So let us draw the x-axis and y-axis. Okay, numbers are plotted. Then we plot the points which we have obtained. Then what we are observing? We are observing a straight line. Alright, students. So today, up to this. Thank you, students.